All right, so now we are going to start looking at Unit 2, which is looking at connective tissues and their histological structures. This 2A video lecture is going to go over the basics and then start talking about some of the loose connective tissue proper. All right, so down here in this little black box, I have a list of definitions of different terms that you might want to reference later on. I'm not going to go over them, but they're right there in case you need it. Okay. So connective tissues. When we were talking about the epithelial tissues, we talked about how they are all closely spaced. There is always a free edge and an edge that's attached to a membrane. Connective tissues are a little bit different. What you want to remember is that the cells typically are widely spaced, so they're not necessarily touching each other, and you're going to have lots of different types of cells, whereas with epithelium it was like you were just seeing a bunch of simple cuboidal cells all lined up next to each other. With connective tissues, you're going to see some white blood cells, fibroblasts, other things, chondrocytes, osteocytes, depending on what kind of cell, what kind of connective tissue you're looking at. Okay. So that's number one, widely spaced cells. Number two, extracellular matrix. An extracellular matrix, so extra, more than, outside of, cellular, so the cell. So first you've got cells, then you've got extracellular matrix. That consists of two things, the ground substance and the fibers. All right, the ground substance is going to be kind of like the background that everything is in. Sometimes it's a liquid syrupy-like consistency, sometimes it's kind of like a jello or gelatin, and sometimes it's a mineral, like in bone. Okay, now what's important, these are all non-living components, right? The cells are alive. The extracellular matrix is not alive. Okay, so function, protection, insulation, transportation of substances, these are all very generic. All right, generic functions. When you're talking about specific connective tissue types, I expect you to give me specific functions. Again, I don't ever want to see you just writing down and telling me something, oh, it protects, because everything in the body is designed to protect something. Okay, I want specifics. We've got four classes: connective tissue proper, cartilage, bone, blood. I am going to focus on Unit 2 on just the connective tissue proper, the cartilage, super brief on bone, and I might mention blood. Okay, next slide. All right, connective tissue proper. So we add this word proper on the end. It's an important word because connective tissue is four different things. It's connective tissue proper, bone, blood, and cartilage. Connective tissue proper is a very specific category, and basically what I think happened is that when it was first defined as a category, it was called connective tissue, and then other people doing more research realized, oh my gosh, cartilage and bone are basically a type of connective tissue. But how do we distinguish that from this other category that we don't have a good name for? So they made a bad name for it, basically, connective tissue proper. So this is like the original, what we defined it and explained it all based on, okay? You, first of all, you've got mesenchyme. This is embryonic. Connective tissue proper, we're not really going to talk about that anymore, other than to mention that when we're looking at a realer connective tissue proper, we often use a form of mesenchyme to explain it and to show what it looks like because it's easier to look at. The only place you're going to really see this is when, other than in an embryo, is when someone is born, their umbilical cord will have mesenchyme in it. Okay, so connective tissue proper, again, terrible definition. The definition I like is it's not bone, cartilage, or blood, which is an awful way to define something, but that's what we're going to use. All right, so first of all, you have loose connective tissue proper, and you have dense connective tissue proper. This is all based on the orientation of the fibers. All right, if the fibers are loose and there's lots of ground substance, then you have loose connective tissue, okay? And you have three subtypes: areolar, adipose, and reticular. All right, dense connective tissue proper, the fibers are densely packed, so packed that there is very little ground substance visible.
okay, because it's all squashed together. Three categories, dense regular, dense irregular, and elastic. Okay, I'm going to be mentioning this multiple times, but elastic, all right, look up here. Elastic isn't about stretching a tissue. It's about whether a tissue can or a fiber can recoil and go back to its original stretch shape. Don't ever say that something that's elastic is good at stretching, because stretching is when you pull things apart. Recoil is when it bounces back. Okay, so I want you to focus, whenever you see the word elastic, on the concept of recoil. So I want you to shift your thinking. It's all about recoil. Next slide. All right, so now we're going to look at the components and organization of connective tissue. Now, this can be generalized to all types of connective tissue. We're going to be using a realer connective tissue proper as our prototype for explanation because it's just so easy to see. All right, so first of all, you have a background that everything is suspended or floated in. That is called your ground substance. So you can see it's basically this stuff. All right, and it's basically, I usually consider it the white or the light, clear background that everything is floating in. Okay? Now, the other part of the extracellular matrix, so ground substances was the first part, protein fibers is the second part. And remember, this is non-living. Okay? I have three kinds of protein fibers, elastic, collagen, and reticular. Okay? Now, typically, what you're going to look for, what you're going to notice first, are going to be the collagen fibers, which are usually very thick. Most of the stains that we use, when you can see the collagen fibers, they're going to be a nice thick pink color. They're very, very noticeable. But don't confuse it with the blood vessels, okay, which are bigger and fatter and usually stain a darker color. Okay? Now, right here, I have reticular fibers, which are basically being done in this brown color right here, okay? Usually when you see staining, these are typically the same color. What is different is their thickness, all right? They are essentially made out of the same protein. They are both about tension, okay? So they resist tension, they resist being pulled apart. Collagen fibers are really thick. Reticular fibers are really thin. Reticular fibers are often used in places, let's change color, places where you need a stroma or structure for things to float on. All right, so it kind of like forms like the struts of a house or the beams of a house for something to hold on to. Whereas collagen fibers are more like a piece of rope or a chain that's preventing something from being pulled apart. All right, elastic fibers, we're going to change the color again right here to green. These typically stain more of a black to purplish black color. All right, they are more noticeable than the reticular fibers. So the reticular fibers will often look like a really faint pink, whereas the elastic fibers, because they're using a different stain, they stain a darker color and they're pretty noticeable. All right, so let's move on to our cells. When you've got a labeled diagram, usually you can tell what the cells, what types of cells they are. When you're looking at a histology slide, because of the amount of experience y'all will have as students, usually you just say, oh, that's a cell, and it's a purple dot or a black dot, okay? So here, because we're looking at a realer mesenchyme, we have a mesenchymal stem cell. Right here, I have a macrophage. Here, I have some adipocytes, so fat cells. Here, I've got a fibroblast. So you can see that I've got, in this case, four different cells that are present, and they are going to be doing different functions. Notice that they're not necessarily touching each other. Right up here, I have another, I'm going to abbreviate it, another fibroblast. Here's another adipocyte, 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 adipocyte. There's another one right there. And then right here is another mesenchymal cell. Okay. Now, if this was a more mature cell, that this would probably have differentiated into a fibroblast. Oh, wait, no, the fibroblast is down here, sorry. Oh, forget that I said that. All right, mesenchymal cell, never mind. All right, so let's move on to the next slide. All right, so here we're looking at a realer
connective tissue. So this is a loose connective tissue proper, okay? Now, what you're gonna notice is, let's look down at the bottom slide first, is I've got all this white space in here, okay? This is all ground substance, all right? So, and I don't even have that label. Let me label that for you. So this clear, the clear stuff is ground substance. Okay. Now I have my dots right here. Now I'm not seeing these dots really all that clearly. They're just kind of dark purplish black dots. These are all cells. If you had a better slide, better magnification, a little bit more experience identifying things, you might be able to differentiate a fibroblast from a macrophage. But for the purposes of what we're doing, if you have a real slide, you can just call them all cells. If you're looking at a diagram where it's been labeled for you and you've been practicing, I expect you to be able to tell the difference between a macrophage and a fibroblast. Okay? All right, so let's see next. We've got our collagen fibers. Collagen fibers are going to be these thicker pink lines, okay? Nice big fat pink lines. All right, the reticular fibers are going to be these really faint pink lines in the background, okay? And then the elastic fibers, oh, that arrow's not in the perfect spot, are going to be these dark staining blackish purplish fibers. All right, so those are the major features of the areolar connective tissue. Now, this is basically from mesenchyme, and we use it because we can get a really great picture where you can see all the structures easily. This is actually what you usually see when you see areolar connective tissue proper, and this is one of the better examples. Sometimes it's so thin you can barely see the structure at the magnification that you have. So a lot of times what you're going to be doing is memorizing that right there is areolar connective tissue proper, okay? And what you can see here, and it's difficult to see at this magnification, but I've got the dark pink lines of the collagen, and then I have the purple dots, which are my cells, and then I have the bits of white space, which is the ground substance. Okay? All right, let's go on to the next slide. All right, this slide is just summarizing the various features of areolar connective tissue. So its fibers are loosely oriented, there's lots of ground substance. Location, you need to know the different locations on where you're gonna find things. This is the basic function of areolar connective tissue proper. It's a supportive structure. It binds tissues. It's a packaging. It provides a medium for nutrients and gases to diffuse. Okay? So diffusion of gases is a really good one. And you store a lot of body fluids in there. Okay? And then also, fights against infection by providing a place for macrophages and other white blood cells to exist. Okay, next slide. All right, so now we're gonna look at another type of loose connective tissue proper. This is your adipose. Adipose means lipids, which means fat, okay? So when you're looking at this, it's really hard to see how this looks like a reeler, because what you see is an enormous cell, all right? And this is the cell membrane. What you're gonna have to do is use your imagination and pretend that you know that I have fibers in between those cells, okay? So the red line is representing fibers. The green line is representing the cell membrane or the plasma membrane. So it's sandwiched in there, okay? I'm also going to have, so this is my cell right here, okay? This is going to be the nucleus of the cell. Within the cell, so all of this, that's going to be the lipids or the adipose, okay? And then occasionally sandwiched in between the cells, you might see things like a blood capillary, okay? So in terms of function, what do you got? Well, insulation, shock absorption, really important thing. So these create little pads around organs, and this is what we also call subcutaneous fat.
Now, the adipocytes are filled with an oil or a lipid, all right? So if it's a, and we're going to divide that up into two kinds, white adipose and brown adipose. Brown adipose, fat storage and padding and insulation, okay? Whereas brown adipose, we're really just going to find that in our babies. That's your baby fat. And that's really the only time that you have it, and it tends to go away as you transition into childhood, okay? All right, going on to the next slide. All right, so we're going to look at reticular connective tissue proper now. So this is also loose, all right? So this is a loose form, which means it has lots of ground substance and just a little bit of fiber, okay? So here I see all this white space. That's going to be the ground substance, okay? Now, what's unique about reticular connective tissue is that it only has reticular fibers. There's no collagen and there's no elastic. And they basically form like this, okay? And they're all over the place. And then what you're going to find are lots of cells hanging out. Sometimes the ground substance looks like it's just packed with cells. Sometimes it's a little bit more scattered, like what you see here. And often these are a type of leukocyte. In this case, we're looking at macrophages. It's also very common to see other types of lymphocytes. So like if you're in a lymph node, you're gonna have lots of lymphocytes, lots of macrophages. Sometimes there's fibroblasts. So a lot of cells in there, and it can be really packed. If you're in the spleen, you're also gonna see red blood cells. All right, now, I want you to focus on this right here, high power. The only reason I can see these cells and fibers so closely, so well, is because it's at a really high magnification under the microscope. These reticular fibers, they're very delicate. They're faint, right? You cannot see them well unless they're under high magnification. And that is a really unique feature to the reticular connective tissue proper. A lot of times it's really hard to see the fibers. So always keep in mind the magnification when you are looking at a slide, okay? All right, so we're gonna end with the reticular there, and the next video presentation is going to start looking at the dense connective tissue propers and then going on to cartilage and so forth.